So at, in round in 76, the government wanted to move in and totally demolish Christiania, throw everybody out. But there was this huge movement that got behind Christiania and saved Christiania's ass. And Christiania has been saved like that many, many times, because from the beginning it was a political, what we call a hot potato, because there were a lot of people thinking, how can they just squat this land and just take this land for themselves, you know, because they're not paying anything, they're not paying taxes, they're not doing anything. And these misconceptions still exist in Denmark, you know, that we're not paying taxes, that we are not taking care of the land, you know, that we're just like lazy squatter hippies, anarchists, you know, that do nothing. But so over the years, but then gradually it changed and Christiania became more and more accepted. And now, back in 2011, Christiania was made a deal with the government that we actually, it's called a normalization process, where Christiania became a legal entity. So there was a foundation, we founded a foundation that kind of takes ownership of Christiania. And it becomes a legal owner of Christiania. It's the foundation is not has a board, but the top authority in Christiania is still what we call the common meeting. So the common meeting is just basically everybody getting together in a meeting and deciding what to do. So Christiania has changed a lot over the last approximately 10 years from being this political project where, you know, they made like, for instance, one time, I don't remember exactly when it was, but the government demanded an answer from Christiania regarding, you know, will they move out or not? And then what Christiania just did, they sent to parliament two jesters, one playing and they said, here's our answer, and the guy played a long flute solo for them, you know, like, as you could just do that kind of happening, you know. And they said, this is our answer, this is the flute solo, improvised. And then the other jester danced, you know, like, that's how I see it in my head, at least. It was never recorded because it was in parliament. So Christiania also could also always ridicule the authorities and play games with them, because at the end of the day, it was a squatted community. So they would have to throw us out, you know, physically to actually remove us from the land. And the land is really in the center of Copenhagen. So the parliament is, you know, 5 minutes away from where we live. And even I live on the outskirts of Christiania, but it is, I think it's the only type of that type of squat in the world. And it's, in a sense, it is very Danish in a way, because Denmark is such a small country. You know, we're only 5.5 million inhabitants. So you don't need many people to get behind your cause, actually, to have connections, you know, into the inner circles of doings, you know, because somehow people are connected to each other. We're all like kind of related to each other. So that has also been one of the reasons why Christiania survived. You know, a lot of influential people over the years have stood up and defended Christiania, and then also there have been, they tried to take over Christiania another time, and then enormous riots broke out, or like the album cover I showed you with the Christiania, that in 76 there was that album went number one in Denmark with the biggest hit, You Cannot Kill Us, You Cannot Kill Us, You Kan Ikke Slå Os Ihjel, which is still like an anthem song for Christiania. So Christiania has won, like, I would say, like a cultural battle in Denmark. And then of course also abroad, by becoming a landmark for Denmark, a place where most people who visit Copenhagen, they also tend to visit Christiania. So in the context of a capitalistic system, you know, then it's good for business, which I have very mixed emotions with, you know, because actually, we've been close for more than 2 months now, and it's great, you know. It's great just only to meet your neighbors, and it's not all this, because, you know, mass tourism. I don't know where you guys live, but mass tourism is pretty invasive into your privacy, and it is one of the things that is one of the major issues that is that Christiania is facing at the moment is this popularity. Actually, Christiania came from being like a place that nobody dared to visit, you know, because it was dangerous, full of drug dealers, you know, big dogs and people you couldn't control, and the police only comes here in like big groups. And then now it's more, you know, accepted place, and it's since we became normalized, started the normalization process, even get people visiting from like cruise ships, you know, like total middle class average people, you know, who are here with the cruise ships. They come, you know, and in big groups, and it's something that is a debate that is going on in Christiania all the time. So Christiania has become a cultural icon in Denmark, and also a cultural reference point many, many places across the world. And basically, we live like 800 people here. I think it's around 800, maybe around 900, between 800 and 1,000. We don't have census very often. But kids and, well, I could, of course, get the right numbers, because, but it's always going to be like a little bit, you know, only in the ballpark, it cannot be exact, but around 900 people, like 750 adults and 150 children. And we actually do pay our taxes. I mean, if you work outside Christiania, you pay your taxes, and we pay the land taxes, but we have our own electricity system. We build our own electricity system. We build our own sewage system. And we have our own, we govern the area ourselves. It's us who decide what goes on in the area most of the time. And we have the maintenance of the land is done by us. All the buildings is done by our own people. And basically it's a community within Copenhagen that is self-governing.